off, let the sun come in. Whoa, for all my dogs to stay down, we up again. Oh, I got dirt on my name, I got white on my beard, I had debt on my books, it's been a shaky ass year. Let me make this clear, so all y'all see, I don't take advice from people less successful than me. Huh? Ain't no love lost, but the gloves off, and we up in this bitch until they turn the club off. Had to tell the dogs, turn the snubs off. Plus they already mad that the Cubs lost.
Believe it or not,
these two wrongs are right you.
Believe it or not,
I was too grown in high school.
Believe it or not,
the true soul of Ice Cube, too close to snipe you. Truth told, I like you. Too bold to type you. Too rich to fight you. Calm down, you light skin.
Alright, we about to get it in. What's up? Happy Saturday, y'all. Happy Saturday. Get my cards together. We about to get in. Waxing, moon reading for the collective. See what we got going on. You know what I'm saying? And the energies and the spirits and the cards and everything. What's up, Queen? Make sure to share this. Share my live. To share it, so I'm about to share my live too.
Ain't no stress on me, Lord. I'm moving forward. Keep moving forward. Keep moving forward. I'm so reborn. I'm moving forward. Keep moving forward. Keep moving forward. Ain't no stress on me, Lord.
How you feeling tonight? I hope you're feeling good. I'm feeling good. I had a little something to drink. I'm nice. I haven't been on. I was on last week, so I said, let me jump on while I'm feeling good. And when I be a little bit tipsy, I be picking up on the spirits. I don't know why, but I said, let me hop on live real quick.
Very rarely do you catch me out. Y'all done specially invited guests me out. Y'all been...
I'm about to get it in.
I was off the chain. I was off the drain. I was off the meds. I was called the same. What an awesome thing. Engulf the shame. I want all the rain. I want all the pain. I want all the smoke. I want all the blame.
Cardio, audio, let me jog your brain.
Yeah,
I done had enough drinks for you. Yes, I'm feeling kind of good. I got 2 weeks left. In my semester, I turned in my papers. All I had to do is discussions. Like, I don't have nothing to complain about. So, I'm living my best life right now. We about to get into the waxing moon. Seen that fall out, right? Alright, I ain't messing with these no more. Two fell out. Damn! This reading about to be hitting already. I already know. This the type energy we got? Alright. This the type energy we bring. I should make this like a series, like my drunk tarot readings or some shit. But this about to be lit.
I'm so
Keep moving forward. Keep moving forward, no matter what. No matter how you feel, no matter if you want to give up, just keep getting, and I promise you, you'll reboot. You'll reboot. That's all you gotta do. For a way out. From the storm. Which way do I go? Shout out to Gems 1982 for the badges. And you know what? I do reading. So if you want to hang on after I go through the reading for the collective, I'll do you a reading, okay? You can ask a question or it could be a general reading. So shout out to Gems 1982 for 2 badges. I appreciate that. Appreciate it. Keep moving forward, y'all. No stress. We're not stressing shit. Because we know that we got everything we need and we're just going to keep moving forward. Alright, so let me turn this off because Instagram is going to try to shut off my live. Alright, so that's the vibe we on. That's the vibe we on right now. Like, no matter what you're going through, if you're watching this now on the replay, because I'm going to leave this on my live, like, we all going through something. You feel me? Like, but that doesn't mean that you have to give up. It doesn't have to mean that you got to think negative. Like, just keep moving forward and keep surrounding yourself around people who want the same things as you, right? Success, quality of life, fitness, positivity. You know what I mean? Like, surround yourself around like-minded people. And I promise you, things are always going to work out, no matter what. Like, I'm trying to tell you. Okay, so this, I'm going to do this little reading right here. This is for the collective, okay? This is for the waxing moon energy. And right now, the moon is in Scorpio. So let me actually see if I have, because I got the waxing moon card. Let me see if I got a waxing in Scorpio. Void. Come on. Full moon. I think it's just this full moon and waning, maybe? Yeah. Alright, so nonetheless, Scorpio energy. So we're gonna set the tone with this card, the waxing moon. Energy is gaining momentum. Energy is gaining momentum. Okay, so we need to look at energy and both in the duality aspect, positive and negative, right? So what this means is that any type of energy is gaining momentum. If you're breeding off of negative energy, that's going to gain momentum and it's going to get stronger, like the dark side, right? And if you're striving and focusing and trying to push that energy to be positive, high vibration, that's going to maximize underneath this energy. So you need to understand that, okay? It goes both ways. Sometimes when we think about aspects of energy and things gaining momentum, especially under the full moon, we tend to forget about the dark side, about the shadow. That's going to gain momentum also if you don't know how to control it and check it, right? So for those of us that are going through things that we're working on our shadow, you need to make sure that you're transmutating. You're transmutating that negative energy into something positive via creativity, working out. You have to transmutate that negative energy into something positive. Because right now, energy is gaining momentum. It doesn't matter what it is. It doesn't matter if it's positive. It doesn't matter if it's negative. All right? So that's what we need to realize underneath the waxing moon. And we didn't even get to the full moon yet, right? We didn't even get to the full moon yet. So I'm going to do a full moon reading, right? And if any readers out there want to collab, feel free to DM me, hit the contact button. We can collab on a full moon. But nonetheless, I'll be doing a full moon reading. So just imagine what's going to happen under full moon. So realize that this waxing period is very strong. And right now, currently, I have this little moon cycle app, but everything is aligned where it's waxing in Scorpio at this time. Scorpio is the number 13, right? If we look at the major arcana, it's the number 13. It's the death card that represents death and rebirth. So I'm telling you, like, you're going to have to transmute that, transmutate energy. You're going to have to transmutate energy because the negative energy will run over anything that you're trying to do and you're trying to create and be successful. Okay, so just kind of keep that in mind, right? So, I didn't even pull no tarot. Hold up, wait a minute, I'm tripping. Let me get the tarot out. So I'm gonna start off with the soul's journey. And here we have adversity and we have perseverance. So I told you, we set the precedent off with understanding that underneath this waxing moon, energy is gaining momentum, whether it's negative or positive energy. And here we have adversity and perseverance, right? And so in order to transmutate energy, you're going to have these two qualities and these two skills and these two traits, right? In order to transmutate energy, you're going to have perseverance and adversity, right? And so for adversity, this card says, I accept that challenges are the best way to learn. How many of us get caught up with the things that come our way, that throw off our square? You know, we don't know how to handle it, problems or situations, and we always look at it as a negative instead of looking at it as a way to build your character. As a way to build your character, challenges that you go through, you're meant to go through them. You know, if you follow me, some of y'all are new, but if you follow me, you understand I have some content out called The Fool's Journey. And it's dealing with the major arcana. From the fool all the way to the universe, it tells a story, right? And there's challenges and obstacles that the fool goes through, each major arcana card. What's up, Salvi Brujito? What's up, my love? But there are obstacles and challenges that the fool goes through with each card pulled in the major arcana, right? And so what would your life be like without challenges, without obstacles, without things to overcome? Would you be the person that you are if everything that you dreamed or you have currently came to you so easily? If you didn't have to work for anything in your life, would you be you? Would you be you? You know, sometimes we all question, why are we here? We all question. I know I do. Y'all, I don't know if y'all want to act like y'all, you know. I question why I'm here. Like, what am I doing here? What's going on, you know? But nonetheless, we are human beings, and all of us collectively go through challenges. We each have obstacles. What's up, Native Moyo? How you doing, love? I'm doing good. But we all have our challenges and obstacles that we go through in our own life. That's why it's not good to compare. It's not good to compare your life to other people, because we all go through things on, it's not the same experience, right? But we all have obstacles and challenges in our life. Okay, that's why we don't really need to judge other people's life path, things that they do, as long as it's not bothering us. Like, why are you worrying about what somebody else is doing? Can y'all hear me? Drop some ones if y'all can hear me. I forgot to put my phone on Do Not Disturb. Drop some ones if y'all can hear me. Let me get some ones if y'all can hear me, y'all. Gotta do sound check. All right, cool. I just want to do some sound check. Cool. All right, so yeah. There are so many things that everybody goes through, you know? And you got to understand that. So this card is adversity, right? I accept the challenges. I accept that challenges are the best way to learn. All right, so you're not going to hear me telling you to be crying and whining over things. Like, eat that shit up. Eat that shit up. Like, what you got on your plate is meant for you. What you got on your plate is meant for you. And it may feel like, why? Like, you don't understand why you got to go through the things that you got to go through. But these challenges are meant for you. Your challenges are not like the next person's challenges. And determining how you respond or react to the situation is going to determine your path and which way you're going to go. Right? I literally, y'all, I really can't talk about it because I got a lawyer. And it's a lawsuit. Right? I had some Final Destination type shit happen to me, y'all. You know what I mean? Like, a car literally fell on me. Like, I'm not supposed to be here. Like, it just had me on a whole, like, just my whole thought process is like, the fuck? Like, I don't have time for dumb shit. Like, we here. That was for a reason. That was for, and I'm still here to tell the story. That was for a reason. That was for a reason. Our obstacles, our challenges, the things that we go through, we supposed to overcome it. And then, you know, if you want to share your story, it's, you don't know who you motivating. You don't know who you motivating. You don't know who, don't worry about likes. It's so many people. Let me tell you, you know what I mean? Like, I done had, y'all see, I be posting stuff, you know, people that are successful or, you know, celebrities or whatever mention me, but they won't say my name. Like, these people be watching everybody. So don't worry about likes and all of that. Like, just do you. Do what you're doing out here for all my creators. People are watching. Them people be watching. Likes don't mean sales. I'm going to tell you that right now. Likes don't mean sales. I'm going to tell y'all that. So just remember that for all my creators out there that just felt like, you know what I mean? Just keep doing what you're doing. I'm trying to tell you. And good things are going to happen. Hard work beats talent when talent don't work. All you got to do is show up. And if you got talent, then it is what it is. And that's my problem. I have my problem with being consistent. You know, but back to this, because, you know, I digress. Adversity. I accept that challenges are the best way to learn. So we got to eat those things. We got to eat all the shit that's coming to us. And we got to learn how to deal with it. We got to learn how to transmutate energy. We want to learn how to be the calm in the midst of the storm. And to be able to overcome challenges. Think of game plans when things happen. Okay, this happened. What's plan B? What's plan C? You feel me? So just kind of remember that. What's the next card? Where's my card? What did I do with the card? Oh, perseverance. I know that I can do whatever I set my mind to. It's a lot of us, including myself, be out here just doubting everything that we do. Because number one, if it don't fit into society, you know, the popular shit, you probably think it's shit corny. And it's like, yo, just do you, be you. Stop worrying about other people. Stop worrying about other people. Just do what you do. Live your life. Create your own wave. Create your own vibe. I'm trying to tell you. It's so many things. Like, when I was younger, y'all, in my younger years, you know, I know y'all think I'm about 31. You know what I'm saying? But I'm Beyonce, Kim Kardashian age. I'm about to be 40 this year, right? And when I was younger, I grew up in a suburban environment, and I grew up in the hood. And I was clown for liking heavy metal, for liking white people shit, love all that shit. Now the younger generation, y'all motherfuckers be doing mosh pits. Everybody want to be a rock star. Like, that shit cool now. But in my generation of where I grew up at in North Philly, that shit wasn't cool. You know what I'm saying? Like, but I still did me. I didn't care. I wasn't going to let what everybody else doing would determine what I would do, you know? And it always made me stand out, and it always made me different, you know? So when you feel like giving in, you feel like you want to do what everybody else is doing, continue to do what you do. You're going to get noticed for that. You know what I mean? Like, everybody got tattoos now. Everybody got piercings now. It's like all the things that were kind of not the norm when I was growing up is like all out there now. And it's kind of crazy to see. But, you know, be you. You know, like, I want to go to etiquette school. I asked my daughters if they wanted to go to etiquette school. They was laughing at me. You know, everybody out here being ratchet, twerking and shit like that. Like, I think it's nice to have manners. You know, to be courteous, ask people how they doing, smile, have a good day. You cross in the street, somebody come by, you say hello. Like, I like things like that, you know? So don't be afraid to be who you are. If you're a nerd, if you, whatever vibe you on, just find your tribe, but don't let people try to change you and make you feel bad for who you are. Okay? I'm trying to tell you, it's 6 billion people on this planet. You're going to find your tribe. For those of you that feel like you don't have nobody, that you're an introvert, or, you know, trust me, and I'm the most introverted, and I'm out here on the internet on live, so, you know, just kind of get through things, understand that you're going to find your tribe, understand that just continue to do what you do. You can do anything you set your mind to, and I'm telling you, if you want success, if you want great things in life, it's not a lot of people that have that same thought process in mind frame, and I'm understanding that now, being on the level that I'm being at, right? I worked myself from the mud up. I was on food stamps. I grew up in a household on food stamps. And I'm saying, like, I make 6 figures, you know, and I never imagined that in my life, you know, but I worked hard. I persevered. I've been in school for like 22 years, y'all. This shit crazy. Like, I'm getting my doctor's degree. Like, I'm into things that other people aren't into, and I'm not afraid. But everything that I've done in my life, the way that I am, the behavior patterns that I am, you know, people try to attack me because I'm OCD, but all of these things have brought me greatness and success. Success, right? Repetition. You know, listening to the same thing over and over, especially if it's affirmation based. All of these things have brought me success. So why would I listen to people that are not successful, that are not doing nothing, that's following the crowd? And here it is, me being different, being who I am, not listening to the same type of music. You know what I mean? Like, a whole different thought process, and I'm continuing to succeed in life. Why would I not continue with the formula that I've been doing, my strategy that's been working? You feel me? So continue. This message is for somebody. Somebody need to hear this. Like, don't give in to the crowd. Be different. Be who you are. Don't be afraid to be who you are. Do not be afraid to be who you are. Continue to persevere. And have adversity through your obstacles and challenges, and everything that's coming your way is coming your way for a reason, because it's a lesson to be learned, whether you like it or not. It's a lesson. Is it that maybe you're in the same situation and you keep doing the same thing? That's called crazy. When you do the same thing over and over, that's called crazy. So that may be the first scenario why you keep being in these challenges. The second scenario, right, you just continuing to keep making the same mistakes, you know, or, you know, maybe there's some generational curses. Maybe there's some things that are in your past life or generational that you've got to break through. And that's a lot of us, especially minorities, poor people, right? We've got a lot of things, generational curses to break through, you know. So, but you're not the only one. It's 6 billion people on this planet. We need to stop feeling like we're not connected. We connected. Trust me. And I'm trying to tell you, I'm an introvert. I'm the introvert of the introvertedness. You feel me? Like, I don't like people, but I like people. Like, I don't even know how to explain it. You feel me? But I'm here live giving you this message, right? So just understand that the things that you're going through, you need to sit back, write out a notebook. If you do tarot cards, you need to get your cards out. If you feel trusted to go to another tarot reader, preferably me, you know, go ahead and get a reading and see what's going on. You know, let's get to the bottom of what these challenges, why do you keep going through these things? What is the lesson? What are you not getting? What is the perspective that you're not taking, that you're not seeing? What are you not paying gratitude for? What are you not being humble about? What are you not speaking up about? What do you won't shut up about? You feel me? So when things keep happening, when you have these obstacles and challenges in your life and you don't know how to overcome them, that's the time to shut your mouth, open up your ears, open up your mind. Listen, take in, right? And so we want to understand that I accept that challenges are the best way to learn. I know that I can do whatever I set my mind to, right? And we understand that we need to say these things. These are affirmations, because we understand that energy is gaining momentum underneath this waxing moon. And right now, today, it's in Scorpio. So you definitely need to utilize that energy. Salvi Brojito was talking about how he was burning candles. Like, we need to be utilizing that waxing and Scorpio energy because it's powerful. It's transmutative. It's death and rebirth energy. Okay, so let's do the candle work. I got the money attraction going. I got the energy clearing going. I do community work for those of you that don't know. It's free for 30 days. If you're interested, click the link in the bio. But now's the time to gain momentum and to utilize that energy, that waxing energy, preferably waxing in Scorpio today, right now, like this minute. You feel me? So next, we're going to go to my self-care cards. And we have energy work. What was I just talking about? Y'all know my readings be flowing, and I'm like extra hype because I'm a little tipsy. And I had a couple shots of Captain Morgan's, y'all. Yeah, so yeah, energy work. Now's the time. And even not today, but just building up to the full moon and doing work on the full moon. Like I'm trying to tell y'all, whatever you're trying to do, whatever you're trying to break through, you'll be able to double that energy if you do some candle work, right? I'm trying to tell you. Energy work. Next, we have drink some tea. And so I feel like when we talk about drinking tea, I get ritual, right? Because there are things that I feel like when you drink tea, right? Look at the card. You know what I mean? Look at her outfit. She definitely got on, like, you know, she took a nice little shower. You feel me? You know, she took like a spiritual bath. You feel me? Like she got on a nice fresh pair of pajamas. She got on some essential oils. Like she's in a vibe. It's a process. So like this card is called drink tea. And I feel like we need to have like a routine or a process or a ritual where we could calm our mind and reflect on things. And drinking tea, what do you do when you drink tea? You know, if you're not talking to somebody, if you're by yourself, you may be reading a book or you may be meditating, but drinking tea should put you in the vibe or the mind frame of relaxing and calming yourself, cleansing, calming, healing, reflecting. You know what I mean? So now's the time to do a lot of reflecting because thoughts create things. And I told you that any energy during this waxing moon all the way to the full moon is gaining hella momentum. Whether it's positive or negative energy. So whichever way you go, whichever way you decide to go with that energy, whether it be left or right, whether it be good or bad, whether you want to turn up or calm down, it's going to gain momentum. The actions that you choose are going to gain momentum. And it's going to set the precedent for things to come forth. Possibly with the full moon setting that precedent, right? So drink tea, ritual, cleansing, spirit. You know, getting yourself together, time to reflect, meditate, calm, be still, be silent, listen. These are all the things that come up with this card for me, right? What we got next? Essential oils. And so I have rose essential oil, and this represents compassion. This represents compassion. The trigger statement is, I am unlovable. That's the trigger statement. When you feel unloved or when people say things to you to make you feel unloved. The true statement is, I am loved, bitch. It wasn't no bitch on it and I added that. But that's what we're going to tell these people out here. You are love. You can never be unlovable because you are in the frequency of love. Everything you do, the way that you are, you just love. What are you talking about? We validating ourselves over here. We don't need nobody else to empower us or hype us up. I gas me up. I hype me up. I don't know if y'all know about Tony Jones. Y'all better look Tony Jones up on Apple Music. I hype me up. I gas me up. Fuck you talking about? I am love. The trigger statement is I'm unlovable. Think about all the people that's ever tried to say things to you and they didn't have to use that direct language that you're unlovable, but they use language indicative to, y'all know I like big words. They use language in reference to trying to come at you and say that you're unlovable in whatever vile, ignorant way that they've done it, whether it was condescending or whether it was just straight out, right? So for anybody that has ever tried to come at you and say that nobody will ever love you, we understand that that's a trigger, and it ain't true, because we are love. We are love. Fuck you talking about? You feel me? Your heart is healing and expanding with love. Spend time showering yourself with that love and then share it with others. You can't do nothing for nobody until you do for yourself. Y'all be seeing my posts. I validate myself. I love myself. Self-love is the best love. Yeah, I be on that Kanye energy. You gotta love yourself, because people gonna tear you down. Everybody's gonna tear you down. People that you never thought could tear you down will tear you down. I'm trying to tell you. If you don't validate yourself, nobody else is gonna validate you. I'm trying to tell you. It has to come from within. That's the only way. That's the only way, and you build for it. It's in there. For those of us that are introverted or feel like we're not loved, right? For those of us that listen to those things, I used to listen to those things. I used to believe that when I told myself, or when other people told me that, when I went through bullying through school when I was younger. I used to tell myself I didn't have no friends, nobody loved me. I learned to love myself. I've learned to love myself for so long that I don't care. Nobody, and being a Capricorn, Capricorn, Sun, Taurus, Moon, Cancer, right? Like, on top of all of that, you know what I mean? Like, I don't care. I don't care about having friends. I'm my own friend. I love myself. Have compassion for yourself. Forgive yourself. Be friends with yourself. Kick it with yourself. Find out about who you are sexually, emotionally. Kick it with yourself. I'm trying to tell you, that shit, you might think it sounds crazy, but a lot of people out here doing people dirty and not loving and don't know how to express love because they don't love themselves. Because they don't love themselves. I'm trying to tell you, okay? So compassion, the next card. This is a blended essential oil. It represents protective, and the theme is immune. The trigger statement is, I am not safe. I don't know what's going on. I don't like when I get things off of cards like this, because I automatically have to speak on any type of violent or domestic situations that may be going on. Or any type of suicidal situations. I'm not a doctor, right? I don't have any type of medical background, but I do know that, you know, this is my little disclaimer, but I will put it out there that if you're feeling some type of way, it's okay to go get medical help. It's okay to seek medical help. And if you're in a situation where you're stuck and you're not safe, you need to let somebody know without letting somebody know if you can. Somebody needs to know about your situation, okay? The true statement is, I am secure, right? Fill any areas of energetic weakness with strength. You can walk easily knowing that you are safe and protected. So you won't have to live in affirmations of knowing that you have and that you are. I am. That's why that saying is used so many times in the Bible. I am. When you say I am, that means you are here. You have arrived. You are in the present. When you say, I am here, I am secure, okay? So when we have those feelings of not being safe, you know, I just explained to y'all how I was in a car accident, and I get triggered on the road. I literally am scared to drive. So this kind of hits home for me. And again, this is immune. When the top says immune, trigger statement is, I'm not safe. True statement is, I am secure, okay? So we just gonna have to affirm, and we gonna have to believe, and we gonna have to live in the present tense and speak when we speak over our life. I am secure. I am love. I know that I can do whatever I set my mind to. I accept that challenges are the best way to learn, okay? Next, we have God's guidance. And I have here green tea. Start delegating. Start delegating. Ask others, including me, to help you instead of trying to do everything yourself. Okay? I just explained to y'all how I recently damn near almost hit six figures. I'm almost there in my corporate job. And if we combine my personal business and my corporate job, I'm over six figures. And I'm going for my doctorate degree. I'm a boss. I'm a wife. I'm a mother. I had to outsource cleaning. Like, I hired a cleaner. You know, I hired a cleaner for 4 hours every week to come do some things. And I feel good because I can focus on other things. And, you know, you're going to have to start delegating things out, you know. And it doesn't cost a lot, depending on where you live at. You can negotiate and have somebody come clean your house for $22 an hour, 3 hours a week. You know what I mean? So stop thinking that these things are not attainable, especially like if you don't have the means. I have teenagers and, you know, they work. I don't have anybody to do these things. So it's okay. Let's start delegating some things out. If you are blessed to have the money to do it, you know, and I feel good because I'm blessed. I have the money to provide for somebody else. I'm helping somebody else's business and he's black. So it's another black business. So it makes me feel good that I've outsourced cleaning and now I can focus on other things, like more things in my business, right? And being a mother and in my corporate job. So start delegating. And I need to tell y'all to start looking for cleaners, right? And they have websites where you can do background checks on cleaners and hire them. Like this one, care.com. I don't know if it's everywhere, if it's just Delaware, but I pay for the membership for the month. I look for whatever I need to look for in the person. I screen, I do the criminal background. So there are ways, okay? And that's the number one thing, especially if you're a working mom, right? Or if you just work a lot in general and you just want a clean space, but you don't have the time to do the cleaning how you want. Let's start delegating things like this out. Delegate the things that you can delegate out, whether it be through outsourcing and paying somebody or other means where you can focus on other things. And it's not taken away from everything. It's, you need more focus and attention on these things, okay? So you have to free your time up. So outsource it, okay? The next one is Irene, and this represents peace. There is no need to worry as everything is working out beautifully, you know? Chaos and order is duality. It's going to happen. That's life. Ups and downs. Those are cycles. It's duality. There's nothing you can do about it but how you respond to these situations, right? And what is your thought process as you are going through these situations? And if you have anxiety, if you're doubting, if you're negative, if you're thinking negativity over your situation, that's what you're going to get. And remember, during this waxing moon, energy is gaining momentum. And it doesn't care if it's positive or negative energy. Energy in general is just gaining momentum. So whatever you're feeding, that's what's going to thrive. That energy is going to thrive underneath this waxing moon, right? Specifically today, waxing in Scorpio. All right, so there's no need to worry as everything is working out beautifully. So just breathe. Breathe. No more anxiety, no more worrying, no more doubt. We know that challenges are going to come. And we know that's just something called adversity. And we know that adversity means that I accept that challenges are the best way to learn. Period. We got challenges in life. And you are built and you're equipped with everything to help you overcome internally and in your external environment. You're just not realizing it because you're focused on being sad or playing the victim in the situation instead of thinking, let me empower myself and be solution, resolution-based instead of victim-based, problem-based. Oh my God, this, that, instead of saying, okay, what can I do to overcome this? That's a lot of people's problems, and about 90 to 90% of the population do not know how to solve problems. They don't know how to complete goals, okay? So you're never going to be successful. You're not going to overcome anything by whining and being the victim, being empowered, understanding that you have the power, whether things go wrong or right. It's your power. You have the power and the ability to get through these things, okay? So perseverance. I know that I can do whatever I set my mind to. If you don't have that thought process over anything that you want, you touch in life, then you get what you get, period. What you put into your thought process over your life is what you're going to get back. If you don't have faith in your own self and your own abilities and your own skills to provide the things that you need, that's what you're putting out. That's what you're going to get back, period, right? So next we have my Trust Your Vibe card. And this is learn. Okay, so during this during the waxing moon.
Ooh, excuse me.
Because energy is gaining momentum, we need to be operating in our feminine energy. Because when you operate in your feminine energy, you're literally you're responding to things that's happening. You're not out here just trying to rush into things and figure things out. Like, allow things to come to you and learn from that. Right? So we had adversity. What did this say? I accept that challenges are the best way to learn. What's this card? Learn. You can't have a victim archetype. The more successful you want to be, and whatever that means for you, success, quality of life, monetarily, emotionally, spiritually. If you want to be successful, whatever that means for you, you have to be accountable for your actions and situations and how you respond to things. You can't continue to put your power off on other people and say, well, because this person did this, I did this. You have to be 100% accountable for your actions to be great, especially if you want to be a leader. When you're a leader, you're literally blamed for other people's mistakes, okay? So you got to be accountable. You might have to be accountable for yourself and others. If you want to be great, you have to be accountable for your actions and everything that you do 100%, 360 all the way around. You can't blame other people. Well, you did this, so it made me do that. None of that shit fly if you're trying to be a successful, like, whatever it is, whatever that means for you, you know, elite, great, like, you know, it just don't work like that, right? Powerful people, successful people, strong people, leaders, they are accountable for their actions and sometimes the actions of others, okay? So right here, we've got adversity once again. I accept that challenges are the best way to learn. And then we have this card that confirms that sit your ass down and learn. It confirms sit your ass down and learn. And stop trying to tell people what to do because you apparently don't know what's going on. So if you're watching this and you're watching this on a rebound, and this is for me too because you know my readings be reading me. Sit your ass down somewhere and learn and stop trying to tell people to do things. It's time for you to take heed. And all the energy and the momentum that you're putting out towards situations is gaining momentum like a snowball effect. So what are you investing your time and energy into? It's gaining a snowball. If y'all can hear me. It's 10:10 right now too on the East Coast. Let me know if y'all can hear me. Drop some ones. I just had my son call and it like was messing up my stuff. I thought I put this on Do Not Disturb. Let me know if y'all can hear me. If you can drop some ones real quick. Please get out. Bye. Go talk to your dad. Okay. Always. All right, cool. Thank you. All right, so learn. And then guess what? Guess the fuck what? Look at this. Time for some crayons. What that mean? We get ready to take this shit back to kindergarten. We think we know so much, but spirit telling us to learn. And get your motherfucking crayons out. Time for some crayons. It's time to take it back to the basics. Sit your ass down and learn. 101. Spirituality 101. It's time to go back. And I see myself in my business and things that I do. I find myself going back to the beginning. Now is the time to go back to the beginning, right? Of things that you may have learned or where you have started from in the first place to put you on the journey. Sometimes you got to double back and do a circle. And this is saying time for some crayons. Learn. It's time to go back. It's time to go back to kindergarten. Like you literally think you go so much. And it's like the game plan, the thought perspective that you have is just not working. And that's okay. It's okay that that your thought process is not working right now. That's okay. Being self-aware, knowing when it's not right, that's dope. That's beautiful, right? I don't do everything perfect all the time, man. I fuck up. But I acknowledge that I fuck up. And then I move forward and I go from there. I don't do the right things all the time. I don't say the right things all the time. But I'm aware. I become aware and I'm like, oh, damn, right? And then you can correct whatever once you become aware, okay? But it's time to go back to the basics, literally. How y'all feeling about this? How y'all feeling about this? Y'all feeling good about this? I'm feeling good about this reading. I'm loving this reading, y'all. Y'all see the scar on my face? This is crazy. I got around every day I wake up. I could have died and I'm here. I'm grateful. I'm humbled. I'm blessed. All right. So next we're going to do Urban Mystic Tarot. We have the Temperance card, which is one of my favorite cards. Sagittarius. This is another transformational type energy. All right. It's another transformational type energy. We have the Strength reversed. All right. For some reason, you think you don't have the strength to move forward. And then we have the Chariot, which has Cancer on there. You see, this is a race car. This is NASCAR. You got to be focused. You got to be focused. You got to have tunnel vision on the things that you want. Sagittarius is about sacrificing. It's fire energy, about moving everything out of your life, burning that shit down. Everything that does not align with what you want and need for the successes that you want in life. For the successes that you want in life. And your spirit guides are there helping you. And your spirit guides might set some shit on fire too, because you won't. The universe and the spirit guides will set some shit on fire for you, because you won't. Right? Sagittarius energy. The universe will set some shit on fire. And your spirit guides, they'll get the shit out your path for you. Right? And you might think that there are obstacles and challenges, but really, they're adversities that you're going through. And we realize that I accept that challenges are the best way to learn. Okay, so you might be mad about the shit coming up, but really, these are the things that you... Oh, I know, boo! I already know. I was like, oh shit, how she come up with the Sagittarius card pulled? I ain't forget what sign you are. Yeah, so these things that we're going through, that we are meant to go through them. And if we don't accept what we go through, the universe is just going to do it, right? Y'all, I'm live and I hear y'all. I'm sorry, y'all. I had to get a little ghetto. Sheesh. Strength. Another fire energy. Another fire energy. Right? This card should not be reversed, but for some reason, we don't think that we have the strength to endure. I told you. Everything that you need is within you already, but you just don't realize that because you've allowed people to tell you that you don't have the strength. And then you've told yourself that you don't have the strength. Do some mirror work. Look yourself in the mirror and say, tell yourself that you can do this. Right? No matter what. Forgive yourself first. We're going to release guilt and shame because that holds you back. Let's do some mirror work. Let's talk about yourself. Talk about yourself to yourself. Look yourself in the mirror. Talk about how beautiful you are. Talk about how nasty you are when you do certain things and behaviors. Like, get honest with yourself. It's a lot of people that don't like spending time with themselves. They don't like themselves. They will hang out with everybody but themselves, right? If you don't know yourself, you're never going to be successful. If you're not self-aware, you're never going to be successful. If you don't know how to respond and the energy that you put out to other people, you're never going to make it nowhere. You got to be aware of these things. And it just makes you better than the rest of the people, because everybody damn near walking zombie. Right? Just knowing how to respond. Behavior patterns, being aware, is going to put you in a whole different ballgame. It doesn't matter what you do, I'm trying to tell you. It don't matter what you do. If you can read people, read energy, read behavior patterns, it's going to put you in a whole other ballgame, because a lot of people can't pick up on that stuff. All right, so you have the strength. You have everything in you. So we have the Sagittarius energy, which is a fire sign. And then we've got Leo, which is reverse, which is a fire sign. And then we've got Cancer, right? The Chariot. We need to have tunnel vision on the things that we want. When you allow people to distract you even a little bit, you are going to continue to push back the things that you want. Your thoughts that you want to create, to manifest, they're going to get pushed back because you keep allowing people to distract you, and then you want to blame them when it's really your fault because you're allowing. Remember, you're allowing these people, places, things, and thought processes to distract you because you don't have no discipline. You lack self-discipline, and then you want to blame other people. You lack self, and look, I told y'all I'm coming at me too. Fags, look, I just told y'all this shit for me too. I'm not just coming at y'all. Way too many distractions and every little thing. Like, you need to have tunnel vision. Y'all know that Kodak Black song? Y'all need to have tunnel vision. It's not a game. Like, everybody, every people, places, like, look, you can't go out this weekend. Okay? You can't go out this weekend. You can't pick up the phone this weekend. You know what I mean? Like, people that, your friend want to come over. Like, nah. You know? When are you going to focus on the things that you want to focus on? Or are you just going to keep talking about it? It's a lot of people that love to talk about the things that they want to do, but it's not a lot of people that do the things that they talk about they want to do. And I'm seeing that as I climb to the top, because I'm climbing, I'm leaving so many motherfuckers behind because all they doing is talking about how they want to climb, but they're not actually climbing. I don't know why I got angry. That's that Captain Morgan's. Nah, but for real though, I'm trying to tell you, it's a lot of people out here that love to talk a lot of shit. Love to talk this and the third, preach, want to give advice about doing shit, and ain't doing nothing to what the fuck they doing. They just talking about it. It just looks good to them. Just the conversation, not the action. And it's just fucking weird to me. Like, what the fuck you going to talk about losing weight or doing this or doing that? Like, you just like talking about it? Like, you actually don't want to know because it takes effort. It takes requirement. It takes discipline. It takes focus. You got to not be doing what everybody's doing. It takes for you to be an individual. 90% of America is overweight. And then when you talk about being healthy, you know, then you're fat shaming. I was 221 pounds almost 2 years ago. I got tunnel vision. I had discipline. Everybody's eating. Everywhere you go, everybody eating. Me too. I was one of them. The buffet, 3 plates. I go to a buffet now. I can't even finish 1 plate. Everybody eating in America. That's what we known for. We fat and dumb and we eat. I don't want to be like everybody else. It was like BBW. Like, everybody BBW. Like, what's going on? No. I'll take being slim. Everybody had dreads. I cut my shit off. I can't. I don't want to do what everybody else doing. I just want to be on a whole different vibe. I don't care. I don't care if you think I'm a weirdo. I've been called that shit my whole life. My name is unique. Literally. That's my name. Like, my mom already set me up to be, you know what I mean? Like, I had to hold this shit down from birth. What the fuck you talking about? I appreciate everybody rocking my energy. You know, it's on the block. That Sag and Leo coming out. Facts, like, I mean, like, I just was pulling from the elbow. Because this is serious. We need to understand how great that you are. And the things that you want to manifest, you can. But you just got to have a little bit of discipline, focus, attention, and understand that you're going to validate yourself. Nobody's going to support you. The greater you are, the less support that you get. I'm walking, talking it, y'all. I done hit 6 figures. I don't have nobody come see me. Nobody hit up my phone. None of that shit. What Jay-Z say? The higher up he go, the less black people he see. Like, I'm trying to tell y'all. The less support I get. I don't have nobody but me to validate myself and to keep going. Because everybody can't get to my level because they don't have the same perseverance. And then motherfuckers want to clown me because I'm OCD. Because I have the same habits and do the same things over and over. That ain't got me where the fuck I'm at. So you can keep clowning me if you want to. I'm getting bread. I done hit six figures. I come from poor. I come from welfare. From fucking food stamps, y'all. Fuck you talking about? A single mom of four. My mom never finished her degrees. I got 3 degrees for her, and I'm about to get another one. Fucking student loan. Don't get a degree from student loan. If you get something, your degrees and what you're pursuing, you're going to get a good job and you're able to pay it off. Like, the thought process of Americans just be wilding me the fuck out. Like, that's why I don't say too much, y'all. That's why I be scared to go live too, because I know for sure motherfuckers would come for me, because I just don't have the same thought process. And they be teaching us, especially minorities, to have a fucking victim mindset. That somebody else can solve your problems. Can't nobody solve your problems but you. Motherfuckers looking for handouts for this person, for that person. They want to blame. Can't nobody solve your problems but you. Nobody. Can't nobody solve your problems but you. Stop looking for other people to validate you and to tell you that you're great and you're beautiful and you're pretty. We need it. And that means that you need to get around people that are like that. But until you can find people that are great and that's going to tell you that you're beautiful, that you're lovely, that you're successful, that you're great, that you can do anything you want to do, you're going to have to tell that shit to yourself. Period. You're going to have to tell it to yourself. Sis, bro, it is what it is. You're going to have to hype yourself up. Joey B won't save you. Facts. You know what I mean? Like, you're going to have to figure this shit out. You're going to have to weigh out your own decisions. Contemplate, strategize. And I definitely have the tools to help you empower yourself. Because I'm not one of them readers. If you click the link in my bio, you see all the tools that I have. I have free resources. I have things to help you empower yourself, because I'm about empowering. You're never going to do anything in life if you're waiting for somebody else to do it for you. Period. All of these things is reading. All of these things are designed to help assist us to get where we need to go. But ultimately, you got to do this shit on your own. I don't give a fuck how many cards I pull. I don't care how many candles get burnt. I don't care how many rituals you do. Whatever religion, whatever, it comes down to your soul and the will with a capital W, the will, capital W-I-L-L, the will. If you don't have the will to want to do anything, nothing's going to get done. That's the drive and that feeling in you when you want to do things, right? If you don't have that feeling within you, you're never going to do anything. And that's where discipline comes from. And sometimes you have to create that feeling. With rituals and doing things that you don't want to do. Being ritualistic. Listening to music and affirmation music. And saying affirmations and listening to things that's going to empower you. When you feel like you don't have the strength to do it. Remember, the strength card came up reverse. Because we be feeling like we don't have the strength. And I be feeling like that. I'm not fucking superhuman, y'all. I'm a human. I do a lot of things. Y'all be seeing me. I be trying to be all cool and calm and collective and shit. I be stressing. I go through things because I'm a human being. Right? But I'm realizing that I have the strength to do this. And I'm going to keep pushing no matter how fucked up it gets. I'm going to stay focused. I'm going to listen to some music that's going to back up the feelings that I need to have until I can create that feeling with inside of me. Y'all know I'm an occultist. I'm not even going to get into that occult shit. You know what I mean? But y'all know the will, the soul. You know, and that's why you have to do energy clearing and you have to cleanse your spirit, because sometimes you take on other people's energy and it weighs you down till you don't want to do things. It can even be your environment where you live. You know what I mean? Some people don't even live geographically where they live at is holding them down, right? Certain areas where there's a lot of death, right? So understand these things. So don't get upset when you have challenges come up. I mean, get upset, cry, whatever. But what I'm saying is, it's not the end of the fucking world. You ain't dead. If you're not dead, that means you are meant to overcome that challenge and that adversity, because you still got a story to tell. You have a story to tell. Whether you tell it on a grand scheme, whether you tell it on a small scheme, we all have a story. And the people that you interact with throughout your life are going to be impacted by you and the stories We're all impacted by each other's experiences. That is why we're here in this time period on the earth as a collective. That's why social media is so big. We're fascinated with each other's lives, with our experiences, with things that we go through. We're rooting for the underdog. Some of y'all been my day ones. Y'all seen how I was. I had shitty ass video camera footage. Look at the resolution now. That shit crisp. That shit clear. I had dirty ass resolution. You know what I mean? I really didn't know how to put my makeup on. I was introverted. I really didn't know how to express any type of personality over the camera. And look at me now. I done came such a long way, right? When we like people and we root for them, we want to see them do good. We love that people want to see you do good, right? And you may not feel like it. People are going to root for you. And especially when you share your story and when you share your experience, okay? So just remember that. So last but not least, okay? And I had somebody that purchased some badges. Don't forget I got badges, y'all. And I'm doing donations. I got 3 cards left. Who supported me with badges? Let me see. Gems 1982, if you still out there, I'm getting ready to do your reading. And I remember I asked you what kind of reading you wanted, and let me see what you said. Let me see. You bought that right at the beginning. You wanted to know when you get married. So I'll talk about that and I'll expound on that. But let me get through these 3 cards. But if you are interested in a reading, go ahead and hit me with some badges. Donate. We'll just do badges. If you want to do Cash App, it's Urban Mystic. If you want to do PayPal, it's uniquedivination.com. So whatever you want to send, I'll go ahead and hook you up with a reading, okay? So last but not least, we have 7 of Wands, the Blasted Tower, and the 2 of Swords, okay? So 7's always, for me, a warning, a caution. That caution, 7 of Wands, your mind, your mental state. Like, watch what you say. Watch what you say about your situation, about the things that you're going through in life. Watch how you speak over what you want in life. Watch what you say about yourself and your loved ones, right? Speak kindly. This is Lord of Valor. It's Mars and Leo on here, right? Be proud of everything, you, yourself, your family, what you represent. Don't be ashamed of anything that you got going on. Don't be ashamed of who you are, okay? Never be ashamed of who you are. Own it. I told y'all, now is the time to be who you are and be you. Don't be trying to fit in and be like everybody else, especially for my creators. Now is the time to own who you are, okay? And live and bask in that glory. Watch what you say over yourself. The Blasted Tower. We got some shit that's getting ready to come down. We may be in the midst of the shit, okay? But allow things to fall, okay? We're going through a process. We're going through a paradigm shift. Allow these things to take place, because if we did not have adversity in our life, we need to accept that challenges are the best way to learn. If we did not have adversity in our life, there would be no way for us to learn and to grow and to build character and integrity, and you find your morals and your ethics and who you are. If you're not challenged with things, how do you find yourself? If you're not challenged with things, how do you find yourself? How do you grow emotionally, spiritually, sexually, socially? If you're not challenged with things, right? If you don't go through things. Lastly, we have 2 of Swords. 2's duality, understanding that we need to have balance. You need to find balance. You need to find moderation in things that you do. Lord of Peace Restored, Libra. Stop investing your time and energy into things that just ain't really for you. And I continue to say this, you know, whenever Libra come up, that's the first thing that come to mind, because Libras love to be everywhere. Investing their time and energy into things that don't even have no concern of them. All right, so we just want to put our energy into things that are for us, that are giving us back the same energy or more. We're not investing our energy into things that just are not for us, okay? All right, so it looks like we got some more donations. Queen Serenity got 3 badges. I appreciate you, my dear. And V. Barcenas, 1984, got three badges too. So.